Hey guys, welcome to yet another ICO review on the Crypto Gurus. We are going to review of Modul Trade, which is trying to create a letter of credit on blockchain without a bank. So we'll try to understand what a letter of credit means, how Modul Trade is trying to eliminate the bank and use blockchain to do it. And we're also going to look at the Modul Trade token and the current status of the token sale and why you should choose to or not to invest in this particular ICO. So I'll start with the simple definition of the letter of credit. So letter of credit is defined as a very complex definition, as you can see from the Investopedia, but I'll make it simpler for you. So whenever there are buyers and sellers who have to make an exchange of goods, and these two buyers and sellers are not based out of the same country or the same market, there needs to be a level of trust. So for example, when a purchase order is released from one particular country, let's say in the Americas, and this purchase order reaches an African country who is a raw material supplier for the production company based out of the US, now in order to for the African company to trust the company based out of the Americas whether a payment will be made or not be made on the basis of his delivery or not, they start interacting with a bank. So there will be one bank which is going to be based out of the Americas, and there could be one, the same or a different bank which could be based out of the Africa. So these two banks will interact with each other and come to an arrangement where they'll create an instrument called a letter of credit. So a letter of credit would be a contract between the seller and buyer, facilitated through the help of banks, which indicates that on meeting certain conditions of delivery, the bank or the buyer is going to clear the payment of the seller. And in order to ensure that the buyer clears the payment, he's going to deposit the same amount in form of a guarantee, in any form, in the form of a check or in form of account balance or in form of a mortgage to the bank which it does business with in the Americas. And the letter of credit is going to be an instrument which will interact with the buyer, with the seller through the bank of the seller which is based in Africa. So that is how the whole chain of work, and when the delivery happens, the delivery of goods happens, and based on the conditions written in the contract, the payment is released from the bank in America to the bank in Africa, which again transfers it into the account of the seller. And now the sad part here is that for doing this and for facilitating this, banks charge a huge fees on both buyer and seller. So to establish the contract and then to order it, there is a fee which is levied on both the buyer and the seller, which is huge, which is heavy to the which can range from 2.5 to even 10% in some cases. So due to this, besides, there are challenges when it comes to working with banks. So for example, access of banks in some, there are a lot of countries which are unbanked, and if you want to import something from there, it becomes very difficult without doing it with the help of a letter of credit. So these are the major challenges which are being faced by using letter of credit as an instrument in case you are importing or exporting goods. So yeah, so this is the current process of B2B trade. So first is the process of establishing a contract. So the exporter and the importer. So the importer applies for a letter of credit with the help of with the bank of importer, which is the issuing bank. The issuing bank sends the letter of credit to the exporter's bank or the advising bank. Now the advising bank sends a letter which is an authentication letter of credit to the exporter, which means that when the importer the importer will agree to make payment to the exporter, when the exporter meets the delivery requirements set out by the importer. And in order to make sure that the importer honors the agreement, the issuing bank and advised bank are going to facilitate the transfer. In case the exporter does not meet the requirement, the advising bank is going to ensure that the payment goes back to the importer. So this is how the contract is established. And looking at the execution, So if you look at when the shipment goes from the exporter to the importer, then there is a documents of final goods receipt are submitted from the exporter to the bank of exporter. The bank of exporter then sends documents to bank of importer, who releases the payment on verifying these documents and then sends it, and then the payment is routed to the exporter, who is the final receiver. Okay, now after the payment is made, there are release documents which are sent from the issuing bank to the importer, right? And the importer would pay the bank first and get release documents. So release documents mean that the certificate which was issued or the contract which was issued is now released, the transaction is over, and the letter of credit is honored from both the ends. So this is how it works currently. So as you can see, it is already a very complex system, and it was two banks of two different countries, and therefore and you know, any blockchain enthusiast would by now have understood that blockchain could do it in a lot simpler way, and that is pretty much what Modul Trade is trying to do here, right? So Modul Trade is a smart contract blockchain based ecosystem where MSMEs, so medium and small, so specially targeted to medium and small industries, so that they can meet, commit and execute trade globally, easily, trustfully and efficiently. So MSMEs are the biggest hit when banks charge such commissions and fees, because they work on low margins sometimes, they work with very small working capital, and it becomes very difficult for them to bear the fees which are charged by the banks. Now, so Modul Trade's value ecosystem is based on multi-sided platform. So this multi-sided platform creates value through the network effect for three, with the help of these three main constituents. The first constituent is trade counterparties. So you have trade counterparties, and these are the users of the blockchain based letter of credit. So there are model of trust in B2B trade cycle. There is instrument for value exchange, which is another protocol. Then there are trade financing. There is trade financing in MTRs to enable transactions, which is another module. Then there is reputational network, and there is global marketplace. So these are technical details. So these three are the constituents. We just need to understand the trade counterparties, third-party trade-related service providers, and third-party trade software developers put together are going to work in creating the blockchain-based letter of credit equivalent system, which is going to create a system which is more flexible, more reliable, more secured, and more cost-effective. And it will be especially more cost-effective because for the MSMEs who have shortage of working capital and who cannot deal with banks easily, right? So this is going to address the following issues. This is going to remove the lack of trust, because it is possible that there could be tension between two countries, and due to the tension between the two countries, there is lack of trust between the business or the trade partners also. The entry costs are high, so and there are import duties already which are imposed in a lot of countries, which are already high, and with an additional fee from the bank, this will also this issue is also a big one, so which is also addressed to a large extent with the help of blockchain. And the third is complexity of trade relation operations. So blockchain based smart contract based technology is going to reduce the complexity and make it simpler for buyers and sellers to interact directly instead of doing it through a bank. So MV also aspires to be an innovative global platform that will easily facilitate participants' access to third parties providing some or more of the following trade related. So along with providing the letter of credit, they're also going to get into logistics, trade financing, tax and bookkeeping, insurance and custom brokerage. So which means that they're not only providing a line of credit, but providing a single window solution to all the aspects of an importer and exporter business while they're doing business between two countries where there is an import duty, where there is a requirement to deal with multiple banks currently, right? So they also have a supply chain tracking on Modul Trade platforms, which is going to help the tracking the shipment, and which is going to be again facilitated and integrated with blockchain. There's going to be a digital thread for additive manufacturing, which is another interesting aspect, but not the core aspect of the product. There are going to be IoT solutions for invoice factoring. So invoice factoring is a way in which one company finances the working capital of another company on the basis of the live receivables or the invoices generated. So this is how the whole ecosystem of Modul Trade is going to work. So the buyer and seller agree on the trade and create a smart contract in the Modul Trade smart platform. Okay, smart contract platform. Now, once they agree and create a trade, they have to honor it, right? So then the MTP blocks money on the buyer's account to guarantee the payment upon delivery. So when delivery happens, Modul Trade will ensure that the payment is made to the exporter. Then MTP instructs bank to reserve funds on the buyer account or credit card. So one is that you can do it through a bank. So MTP will then instruct bank to reserve fund on the buyer account. Or B, MTP reserves fund for cryptocurrency within the smart contract. So they are providing two options here. So Modul Trade can also work with the current fiat currency, while it can also work with the cryptocurrency. In case when payments are made through cryptocurrencies, there is going to be no involvement of a bank, and therefore the cost of execution is going to go very down, very low, because of no involvement of any bank, no involvement of any instrument like a letter of credit which exists now, right? So this is something which is going to create a revolution in the letter of credit industry. And this could affect the trade finances of a lot of banks if this concept becomes successful. Now, once the reservation of fund is made, the seller sends goods via logistic company and submits tracking number to MTP. So MTP also gets a tracking number of the goods which are sold or goods which are sent. Then upon buyer's receipt of goods, when the buyer does a receipt of goods and he agrees that he has received goods in the condition that he required, in the right number, in the right quality, the tracking delivery also matches the address of the buyer indicated in the smart contract. That also happens automatically. MTP instructs release of payment to the seller. So if you see, the number of steps here is reduced from 11 to 10, from 10-11 to 3-4 only. Besides, since there is no manual intervention, there are no bank officers, there are no bank employees, it is all going to be done with the help of a blockchain. The cost of this particular letter of credit with the help of a blockchain is going to be very low. It is expected to go to as low as 1% of the total cost. And also, since this is all created on a system within the blockchain, it can do it targets to do 1 million transactions per second, which is going to create a very fast process for doing execution as compared to going to the bank, submitting documents, then the exporter going to another bank, submitting the documents, then coordination between the importer and exporter, coordination between the two banks. All this coordination would be done with the help of MTP smart contracts, which are Ethereum based contracts, which are blockchain based, hence secure, very reliable and cost effective. So looking at the market now, so expected number of clients or the potential number of clients that a Modul Trade can have is close to a 400 million plus. So there are that many small enterprises. Even 1% of that would be 4 million. And if they are able to achieve or reach out to even 1% of the total enterprises that are a part of their target segment, I am sure that they can generate a lot of revenue through this particular platform. The transaction that they are looking at, 6 to 7 trillion plus in B2B e-commerce. Obviously, they are targeting a specific segment currently, which is B2B e-commerce. And they're not targeting another segment in which, you know, which is the right thing to do to start with one of the segments of business who are tech savvy, who are willing to adopt new technology and make use of things like smart contracts while they are transacting with each other. Now, looking at the token, so you can go and buy the token of a Modul Trade. The token's name is MTR, the small c. You can go and buy it on their website. As you can see, there are close to 6.5 million tokens which are already distributed. And so that's how it is. And I'm banking on the concept, the innovation that is being shown by the concept, the kind of revolution that it can bring in the world of trade finance when it comes to international business. I think there's huge potential, and which is the reason why they've already hit their soft cap, and they are already into the fourth phase or in the last phase, and they're offering 5% discount. So 700 MTRC is available for one Ethereum. You can go to their website, log into their website, and start making investment from there. There are only 5 days to go, so I would suggest that you hurry up. So the token distribution terms of this, they're keeping a soft cap of close to a 5 million MTRC and a hard cap of 30 million MTRC. The accepted currencies are Ethereum, BTC, LA, and Fiat. The token price, as I told you, is 700 MTRC will cost around 1 Ethereum. And this is the number of tokens that you can buy through token sale. And this will end, these terms of 5% discount are going to end on 27th of January. So there are only 4 to 5 days to go. So please hurry up and grab this offer if you are interested in this ICO. Right, so I think that's it from my side. But I would still suggest that you do your own diligence before buying into this ICO. Please make sure that you go to their website, and please make sure that you go to their white paper if you want to understand in detail what they are trying to do here. If you are convinced about the concept, and if you feel that my inputs were of any use to you, please like this video, and then please go and invest into Modul Trade. So stay tuned for another videos on ICOs and cryptocurrency related stuff. Thanks for now. Bye bye.